मेरा माननीय सदस्यों से पुनः आग्रह होगा कि कोई सदस्य बोलते हैं, महत्वपूर्ण चर्चा हो रही है तो कृपया बातचीत करनी हो तो बाहर जाए, उनको व्यवधान होता है। प्रोफेसर श्री ए नवनीत कृष्णन जी, सॉरी, यस।
थैंक यू सर, दिस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट ओकेशन दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी हैज बीन गिवन टू एआईएडीएमके एंड I very humbly submit certain things subject to correction, because now all the members have spoken on a particular line, but I want to present a different line, because in the light of the decision rendered by the England court, because the England court has held that prorogation of a parliament is justiciable, it is amenable to its jurisdiction, and valid judgment can be rendered. So in the light of that judgment, and also is the honorable members know better than me, only for the sake of completion I am pointing out the articles of the constitution. I am not telling anything new. The definition of state, I would like to draw the kind attention of this court, the house. Article 12 defines what is state. In this part, unless the context otherwise requires, the state includes the state government and Parliament of India and the government and the legislature of each of the states and local or other authorities within the territory of India or under the control of the government of India. So, in the definition of state, the Parliament of India is specifically mentioned. So now my humble submission would be, we are conducting the proceedings in the last session is highly productive, quantitatively and qualitatively, but in the regarding the stalling or washout or obstructing the proceedings, my humble submission would be that obstruction cannot be stretched, cannot be taken or to the extent of the entire session or the entire day. It can be confined to a particular time period in an effective manner. So my humble submission would be to this august house, subject to correction, I am very carefully telling that I never assert what I say is correct. But we have to stress without distress. So we must, because, and also we must drive our point, but not to the extent of the stalling the entire proceedings to the whole day or to the whole session. I think it is unconstitutional, illegal, it is not permissible under our parliamentary sovereignty system, because in our democracy, parliament is sovereign. The parliament must function all the 24 hours. From the reading of this the UK judgment, what is expected from the parliament is, and because that is why it is called the sovereign, it must function all the 24 hours, and it must make the government accountable to its acts or failures. That is the scheme, that is the rule of law, that is the democracy which is we contemplated, which we want to have. But in practice, but of course from the cursory reading of the judgment of the UK, the committee meetings and evidences are not taken during the prorogation. But in our system of parliamentary practice, we are taking evidence, we are holding committee meetings, though the parliament is not in session, but we are following a very good practice. So my humble submission would be, but I am saying, sir, autonomy of the state is always affected by the center. Whether the party in power is A or B, it is immaterial. For example, NEET. We people of Tamil Nadu is suffering. Now many irregularities, illegalities are coming out in conduct of the NEET examination. We are having a very good infrastructure. We are having a very good talent in medicine field. But the central government is enforcing NEET on Tamil Nadu, because in Tamil Nadu legislature, without any opposition, the two bills have been passed. But these bills are not able to be reached the office of the Honorable President or His Excellency President. So my humble submission would be, I am not telling this government, that party, this party, that is immaterial. We are always aggrieved persons in the state, especially Tamil Nadu is aggrieved. Whether the party in power is A or B, it is immaterial. So for example, the NEET. So my humble submission would be, the parliament must be in session always. So we must make the government accountable all the 24 hours in a day, and all the functioning of the parliament cannot be stopped even for a minute without any justiciable reason. This is my understanding of this reading of the books and other materials. This is so, because my humble submission would be, yes, because now why I am reading, I have read the definition of parliament of the parliament of India is also state. The state cannot act arbitrarily. Yes. It is settled in law. So our senior Sumandra is very much here, because arbitrary act are prohibited. The state cannot act arbitrarily. Now, the obstructing the parliament proceedings for the whole day, or the week, or the whole session is impermissible. This is my humble submission. So now, whatever other means, if there is no ways and means to get our grievances redressed, we must find out, we must innovate it, but not by stalling the proceedings of the House. So, and also, definitely a day will come that writ will be filed in the Supreme Court of India. If not in the Supreme Court of India, definitely in the High Courts of any of our any High Courts, at least in the High Court of Delhi, because it will lie against the Parliament of India. Nothing wrong in it, because its proceedings are arbitrary. It, because the stalling the proceedings is not a proceedings of the Parliament or proceedings in Parliament. I may be permitted to read one passage from the UK judgment. No. There must be a business transacted. Then only it can be termed as proceedings of the parliament or proceedings in parliament. So, sir, what is it? Wait. So now, this is for the kind consideration of our honorable members. So we must find out our ways and means. Now we are suffering need. Our young girls, students are committing suicide. There is no other goal. One minute, sir. No. Sir, paragraph 68. No, sir. No urgency. Right. The prorogation itself takes place in the House of Lords and in the presence of members of both houses, and it cannot sensibly described as proceeding in Parliament. It is not a decision of either House of Parliament. Quite the contrary, it is something which is imposed upon them from outside. It is not something upon which members of the parliament can speak and vote. It is not something upon which members of parliament can speak and vote. The commissioners are not acting in their capacity as members of the House of Lords, but in their capacity as royal commissioners carrying out Queen's bidding. They have no freedom of speech. This is not the core or essential business of parliament. So quite the contrary, it brings the core or essential business of parliament to an end. So the obstructing the house is bringing the core essential business of parliament to an end. So it is worse than prorogation. This is my humble submission. So my humble submission would be, and also the protection given to the members also, I would like to draw the kind attention to Article 105, subclass 3, subclass 2. No member of parliament shall be liable to any proceeding in any court in respect of anything said, any vote given by him in Parliament or any committee thereof, and no person shall be so liable in respect of publication by or under the authority of House of Courts. So only for the anything said, any vote given, the protection is given. So now we are obstructing the House, then it is an illegal, unconstitutional. So we can express our concern only in a limited manner, in an effective way, without obstructing the House. This is my humble submission. And also, I may be permitted to read Article 122 of the Constitution. Courts not to enquire into proceedings of the Parliament. The validity of any proceedings in Parliament shall not be called in question on the ground of alleged irregularity or procedure. And also, no officer or member of the Parliament in whom powers are vested by or under the Constitution for regulating procedure or conduct of the business or for maintaining the order in Parliament shall be subjected to jurisdiction of any court in respect of the exercise of by him of those powers.
Conclude.
Those powers.
Conclude.
So even an individual member of Parliament may be called upon to answer by our citizen. So this
Conclude
is my
now.
View, sir.
Conclude.
Sir, now, yeah, again at the risk of repetition, I am telling neat. The central government has no constitutional power, statutory power, even the prerogative power or common law power to retain these bills. So it must be automatically go to the president. President also must give
please conclude.
Consent
please.
Automatically. And
please
then
conclude. If, I will invite now.
If at all the center wants, it can bring a bill and the bill become the property of this house. So now we need Tamil Nadu is
please conclude.
Most aggrieved state.
Thank you.
The students are suffering.
Thank you.
Please render justice.